हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो यू आर गिवेन अ करंट कैरिंग थिन शीट. सो दिस इज अ करंट कैरिंग थिन शीट व्हिच इज इनफाइनाइट इन दिस डायमेंशन. इट इज इनफाइनाइट बस, बट इट्स विड्थ इज बी. इट इज वेरी थिन. सो इन द जेड डायरेक्शन इट इज वेरी थिन. ओके, सो दिस इज अ इनफाइनाइट थिन शीट व्हिच इज इनफाइनाइट इन ओनली वन डायमेंशन. ओके, infinite in the along the y axis. Along the x axis the width is b. Now in the plane of this sheet we have a point p. In the plane of this infinite sheet we have point p. Okay, at a distance x from this end then find the magnetic field at point p. So now to find the magnetic field at point p, what will you do? You will take an elemental line wire. So at a distance r, let us take a wire of thickness dr. Now this element behaves like an infinite current, infinite straight current carrying wire. So this element behaves like an infinite straight current carrying wire, and you already know the magnetic field due to an infinite straight current carrying wire. What is the magnetic field due to an infinite straight current carrying wire? Magnetic field due to an infinite current carrying straight wire. So it will be mu naught I upon 2 pi r, right? So this is the element. Now see, B width has current I. So if B width has current I, then unit width will have current I by B. Then dr width will have current I by B into dr, and that will be called di. So what will be the magnetic field due to this element? So due to this element, the magnetic field will be dB is equal to mu naught. Instead of this I, we will write di divided by 2 pi r. That is mu naught I upon 2 pi b into dr by r. That is the magnetic field will be integration dB, that is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi b integration, all these are constant, I, B, mu naught, 2 pi. So integration dr by r. Now what are the limits? So first element is at r is equal to x, and the last element is at r is equal to x plus b. Okay, so the magnetic field will be mu naught I upon 2 pi b. Integration of dx upon x is ln x. So integration dr upon r is ln r. I have already put the limits here. So answer will be mu naught I upon 2 pi b ln x plus b upon x. Okay. Now why we have directly integrated dB? Because for every element, the direction of the field will be inside the plane. So the answer will be mu naught I upon 2 pi b ln x plus b by b, and the direction will be inside the plane. Why the direction will be inside the plane? Because again, point your thumb along the current. If you point your thumb along the current, the fingers are curling inside the plane. So here the fingers are curling inside the plane. Okay, so the magnetic field will be inside the plane. All right. Okay, now again we have the same straight current carrying sheet, thin sheet, infinite thin sheet of width B, but this time we are asked the magnetic field at a point P, which is which is at a distance r along the perpendicular bisector. So this is the bisector. This is b by 2. This is b by 2 and this is b by 2. Okay, so here again at a distance x, take an element of width dx. Take an element of width dx. So again, di will be how much? Di will be I dx upon b, like the last case. Di will be in the current in this will be I dx upon b. Okay, so now what is the magnetic field due to this element at this point? So for that, first we need to find the distance. Now this is x, this is r, this is a right angle triangle, then this length will be under root r square plus x square. Okay, so dB will be equal to mu naught di upon 2 pi r, that is 2 pi under root r square plus x square. Replace this di with this, so you will get mu naught I dx upon 2 pi b under root r square plus x square. This is r. Okay, so now this time listen to me very carefully. So what is the direction of the magnetic field? So if you point your thumb, so if this is the direction of the current along the sheet, this is the direction of current along the sheet, so point your thumb along the current. So again you will see that there is the curl is clockwise. So the curl will be like this, and the magnetic field dB will be perpendicular to this line. This is dB. Now let us assume that this angle is theta, then this angle will be 90 minus theta, because this dB has to be perpendicular to this line. Okay, now if you take a symmetric element here, you will see that this symmetric element will have a field. This symmetric element will have a field in this direction. Okay, so the resultant field will be, the resultant means for one element dB, you will need only this component. So this component will be what? The field will be in this direction. I will show you the two dimensionally how to see. See, two dimensionally how do you see this? See, what you have done is you have taken a side view. So you view it from this, the bottom view. When you see from the bottom, what will you see? When you see from the bottom, you will just see this line, and all these things will be inside the plane. So let us have a bottom view. So this is the bottom view. And the current that you will see is from here. The current is inside the plane. All right. So if the current is inside the plane, now from, and this is the point P in the perpendicular bisector at a distance r, and you need to find the magnetic field at point P. So you have taken this element. If you take this element, you will see that, so this element is not a point, this is a wire, this is an infinite wire, and the current is inside the plane. So if you point your thumb along current, you will see that you are rotating clockwise. So this will be the direction of the magnetic field dB. But if you take the symmetric element here, you will see that due to this, the magnetic field will be in this direction. So you will see that this component will get cancelled out. This component and this component will get cancelled out. So for any element, you need only this component. And if this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. So you will basically need what? You will need that component along the sheet. So dB is what? Mu naught I by B dx 2 pi under root r square plus x square. So B will be what? Integration dB cos theta. So again, I will come here. So b will be integration db cos theta. Okay, so if b is integration db cos theta, then you will write from here, you will see that cos theta is what? Cos theta is r upon under root r square plus x square. So from this you will get mu naught I upon 2 pi b, r is a constant. This distance is a constant, r. Okay, integrate it from integration of dx upon r square plus x square. Root of r square plus x square multiplied by root of r square plus x square is r square plus x square. Now, what will be your integration limits? So you have measured that x from this point. So this will be minus b by 2 and this will be plus b by 2. So integrate it from minus b by 2 to plus b by 2. Okay, now if you know the integration of this, you know that this integration is tan inverse 1 by r, tan inverse x by r. So I will tell you again, integration of 1 by a square plus x square dx is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So here instead of a there is r, so 1 by r tan inverse x by r, integrate it from minus b by 2 to b by 2. So from this you will get, if you place the value of x as b by 2, then you place the value of x as minus b by 2, finally you will get magnetic field is equal to mu naught I, r getting cancelled, mu naught I upon 2 pi b, 2 tan inverse b by 2 r, 2 2 also getting cancelled, and you will get magnetic field is equal to mu naught I upon pi b tan inverse b by 2 a. So this is the magnetic field due to a infinite thin sheet at a perpendicular bisector point. The magnetic field will be mu naught I upon pi b tan inverse b by 2r. The magnetic field due to this infinite sheet will be mu naught I upon pi b tan inverse b by 2r. Okay, now let us assume that this, listen to me carefully now, let us assume that this sheet is infinite in both dimensions. So here also it was infinite, length also infinity, breadth also infinity. In that case, replace this b with infinity. You know that tan inverse infinity is pi by 2. So pi by 2, pi getting cancelled, you will get mu naught I by 2b. But b is infinite. So what you will say is I by b is suppose k. K is current per unit length. Because b is infinite, you cannot use I by b. But I by b is what? Current per unit length. So current per unit length is I by b and you will replace it with k. So you will get the formula for an infinite sheet, infinite in both dimensions, is equal to mu naught k by 2. Okay, so again I am repeating, the magnetic field due to infinite sheet, infinite in one dimension, is mu naught pi, mu naught I upon pi b tan inverse b by 2r. But if both dimensions are infinite, then you will see that the formula becomes mu naught k by 2, where k is the current per unit length. It comes out to be constant. K is constant, mu naught is constant, 2 is constant. That is, it is independent of r. Whatever be the r, the field will be same. Okay, if you remember, it is similar to electrostatic thin sheet. In electrostatic, the infinite thin sheet, the field was sigma by 2 epsilon naught. It was a constant. It was also independent of x or r. Here also it is independent of x or r. Okay, so the magnetic field due to an infinite thin sheet carrying current per unit length k is equal to mu naught k by 2. Okay, again it is independent of r. And the difference with electrostatics is, so in this was the electrostatic thin sheet, charge density sigma, the field was normal. But here the field is not normal, but field is along the sheet. So here the field is along the sheet. In electrostatics thin sheet, the field was perpendicular to the sheet. So this is the difference, there is a difference in the direction. So direction is along the plane of the sheet. Direction is along the plane of the sheet. Again, I will repeat, direction is along the plane of the sheet. Now I'll tell you a shortcut to find the direction for an infinite thin sheet. See, this is the infinite thin sheet. What you will do is, again I have written it is independent of distance. What you will do is you will point your finger, point your thumb along current and see how you curl. You curl clockwise. So you curl clockwise, that means here the field will be, this time the field will not be circular. The field will be a straight line. But curl of the finger is towards right. So here the field will be right. And at the bottom, you'll see that the curl is towards left. So if the curl is towards left, that means here the field will be towards left. The magnitude will be same, mu naught k by 2, mu naught k by 2. But the direction will be opposite. Above it will be towards right, below it will be towards left. So now let us take one problem here. You have two current carrying sheets, infinite sheets. So you have two infinite sheets. You have two infinite sheets. And the current per unit length is given as, current per unit length is given as K. The current per unit length is given as K. You need to find the magnetic field at this point A, at this point B, and at this point C. Okay, so to find the magnetic field at point A, listen carefully. Due to this thin sheet, current is inside the plane. Place your thumb along the current. You will see that the above it, the curling is towards right, and below it the curling is towards left. So this blue represents first sheet, and this yellow represents second sheet. So due to this first sheet, here it will be right, here it will be left, here it will be left, and due to this second sheet, the current, it is outside the plane. So point your thumb outside the plane. When you point your thumb outside the plane, you will see that the curling is towards left above it and towards right below it. So towards left above it and towards right below it. Okay. Now they have given you the current magnitude is same, II. That means what? That means here these two will exactly cancel out. Why? Because it is independent of distance. This distance or this distance. No matter whatever be the distance, the field magnitude will be same. So here the field will be zero. Here also you are seeing that they are in opposite direction. So here also the field will be zero. But here you will see that they are in same direction. So here the field will be double of individual fields. So here the field will be mu naught k by 2 multiplied by 2. That is equal to mu naught k. That means when you have two infinite parallel sheets carrying current in opposite directions, inside the field will be double of 1 and outside the field will be 0. This is just like a capacitor. Sigma minus sigma, inside the field is there, outside the field is not there. Okay, because the capacitor consists of two parallel plates which are equal and opposite charge. Here also it is equal and opposite current. So it is similar to what you have studied in capacitor. Okay. Now we will study the magnetic field due to a current carrying ring. The magnetic field due to a current carrying ring. Suppose this is a ring which is carrying current I in an anticlockwise direction. Suppose we take this small element. This is the small element, and this element we call it dl vector. The direction of the current is along the tangent. Okay, so dl vector direction is along the tangent and the magnitude is dl. So by using Biot-Savart's law, you will say that dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I dl cross r. So dl cross r, so you will see that dl and r, we are finding the magnetic field at the center. So dl, this is r vector, this is dl vector, and the angle between dl vector and r vector is 90 degree. Okay, upon r cube. So here r one getting cancelled out, and you will, and sine 90 is 1. So you will get dB is equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi r square dl. But you will see that I is constant. Capital R is also constant. So dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by r square dl. Here dl is the only variable. So if you take this element, if you take this element, then also you will see that wait. Okay, listen carefully. What is the direction of the dl cross r? So that point your finger along dl, curl it along r. So you are seeing that the direction is out of the plane. The direction is out of the plane. So I will write the direction here is out of the plane. The direction is out of the plane. So if you take this element, then also you will see that dl is towards the tangent. Dl is towards the tangent and r is this. So dl cross r is still out of the plane. That is for every element. That is for every element. For every element. For every element, the current, the field is out of the plane. For every element, the field is out of the plane. That means you can directly say that B is equal to integration dB, because for every element, field is in the same direction, so you can directly integrate. Integration means what? Integration means summation. So in some cases you have to take the component to sum. In some cases you can directly integrate. Why? Because in this case every element points the field in the same direction. See, this is not scalar integration, this is vector integration. So if they are in same direction, then you can directly integrate. But if all elements gives you field in say random direction, then you will have to take the components. Understood? So here, since the field is in the same direction for every element, so you will directly integrate. All these are constants because the radius is constant. So integration dl. Now integration dl will be the total length, that is 2 pi r. So the formula for magnetic field due to a current carrying ring or the current carrying circular loop, you can also say it as a current carrying circular loop, is given by mu naught I upon 2 r. Suppose this ring has n turns. In that case, you just have to multiply it by n. Then it will become mu naught ni by 2r. That is b becomes equal to mu naught ni by 2r. Right? If you want to find the magnetic field at the center of any arc, subtending an angle theta, in that case you just this is due to the ring and multiplied by theta upon 2 pi. This theta is in radian. So here, suppose you are given a semicircular ring, then it will be mu naught I upon 2r pi upon 2 pi, that is multiplied by half. That is mu naught I upon 2r multiplied by half, that is mu naught I upon 4r. If you have a quarter ring, then you will say that theta is equal to pi by 2. In that case, you will write pi by 2 divided by 2 pi, that is 1 by 4. So it will become mu naught I in upon 2r into 1 by 4, that is mu naught I upon 8r. Okay. Now, very important thing is the direction of magnetic field at the center. So for the direction, what you will do is curl your fingers along the current. So curl your fingers along the current. The direction of the thumb gives the direction of magnetic field. So if the curl is along this direction, then the field will be upwards. If the curl is along this direction, then the field will be downwards. Or if the curl is along this direction, then the field will be downwards. Means inside the plane. If the curl is along this direction, then the thumb will be outward. That is, the field will be outside the plane. Understood? Now if you draw the magnetic field line of this ring, so you will see that the magnetic field along the axis is a straight line, but any other line which is not along the axis, it is a curved path. We can only find the magnetic field due to ring on the axis points. Now we have found out at the center. Now we have to find out at any random point on the axis. That we will do it now. Okay, this loop as a magnet I'll discuss later. See, now what we will do is we will find the magnetic field on the axis of a uniform current carrying loop. So this is a uniform current carrying loop and this is the axis. This is the uniform current carrying loop and this is the axis. So you will see that this is the current carrying I, and you need to find the magnetic field at this point P on the axis. Okay, so let us take this current element DL. This is DL element. Okay, so this is DL element. Now this DL element is at a distance of suppose R, then this is the radius. Radius, let the radius be capital R. Let the radius be capital R. This is the point. Suppose this, let this distance be X. So this is capital R. This is X. Then this distance will be how much? Under root capital R square plus X square. Now I have drawn this diagram. This diagram. In this case, I have taken this in this ring. I have just taken drawn this ring in the different way. Now the ring is, first we have drawn the ring like this, now we are drawing the ring like this, like this. Okay, so the dotted lines here means inside the plane, and this bold line means outside the plane. So that means the current in this loop is from inside the plane towards the outside the plane, that is in this direction. Okay, in this direction. If you are seeing my video, you will see, you can see my the movement of my hands. It is in this direction. Okay, now we need to find the magnetic field on the axis. So this is the axis, and we need to find the magnetic field on the axis at suppose this point P, which is at a distance X. All right, now let us name this point as M and this point as N. So at this point M, you will see that the current direction is out of the plane. This is out of the plane. So at this point, you will see that the current direction is out of the plane. And at this point N, you will see that the current direction is inside the plane. So here the current direction is out of the plane, and here the current direction is inside the plane. Why? Because it is coming from outwards, and here it is getting inside. Okay, so now let us take this element M, this element. So the magnetic field due to this element, apply Biot-Savart's law. So this is R, this is X, this is small r vector, and this is basically the magnitude of small r vector is, and I have written it, under root R square plus X square. So I have written it here. So the magnitude of small r vector is under root R square plus X square. Okay. Now due to this current carrying wire, this is R vector, and DL vector is out of the plane. So if you do DL vector cross R vector, so DL vector is out of the plane. You can see this is DL vector is out of the plane, and R vector is along this direction. So dB vector will be in this direction. So this is DL vector, this is R vector, DL cross R will be in this direction. DL cross R will be in this direction. Okay, so this is dB. So let us find what is dB. So dB due to the current element at M is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I DL, the length of this element is DL, cross R, that is DL into R into sine 90. Why sine 90? Because this R vector is in the plane of the screen that you are seeing, and this current is perpendicular to the plane of the screen. So definitely a vector which is perpendicular to the plane and one vector which is on the plane, that both the angles has to be 90 degree. So DL into R into sine theta is sine 90 divided by R cube, one R getting cancelled out. So you will get mu naught I DL upon 4 pi. Now what is this R? What is this R? Under root R square plus X square. So what is R square? Under root R square plus X square whole square, that is capital R square plus X square. All right, so this is the magnetic field due to this element, but this is in this direction. Now let us find the magnetic field due to this element. Due to this element, the current is inside the plane. You can look at my fingers in the video. The current is inside the plane, and you have to point the point your fingers along the current, curl it along the R vector. So this is your R vector. So curl it along the R vector. The direction of thumb is coming in this direction. So this is suppose db dash vector. Now you will see that this vector component, db vector component and db dash vector component will cancel out. So that means for any element, you need only this component. For any element, you need only this component. Okay. So let us assume that this angle is theta, this angle is 90. So this angle has to be 90 minus theta. So that means if you you need to integrate db cos 90 minus theta. So only db cos 90 minus theta, that is db sin theta, is required for from every element. Db cos theta will cancel out with a symmetric element. This is true for all the symmetric elements. This two. For any element you will do, db sin theta will be required and db cos theta will cancel out. Okay. So now b is equal to integration db sin theta. And db is mu naught I upon 4 pi dl upon r square plus x square. Okay. I have written dl here. And sin theta, see sin theta. Sin theta is what? R upon under root r square plus x square. R upon under root r square plus x square. Integration dl. All these things are constant. This distance is constant. This capital R is constant. So the only variable here is dl. So when you do integration dl, you will get 2 pi r. Integration dl is what? Total length is 2 pi r. So b will be equal to mu naught I r square upon 2 into capital R square plus x square whole ki power 3 by 2. Now if you have n turns in the coil, just multiply it with n. So you will get magnetic field is equal to mu naught ni r square upon 2 into r square plus x square. Now if you want to find the direction of this field, see direction of this field, then curl your fingers along the current. The direction of the thumb gives the direction of field. So if you curl your fingers along the current, the thumb is pointing rightwards. That means the direction of field on the axis at every point will be rightwards. So this is the direction of field. Here also this is the direction of field. Okay, I hope everybody has understood. I will again repeat the formula for you. The magnetic field formula for a current carrying circular loop, which is carrying a uniform current at any point on the axis, is equal to mu naught I capital R square upon 2 into capital R square plus x square whole ki power 3 by 2, where capital R is the radius and x is the distance from the axis, distance of the point P from the on the axis. Okay, now let us check whether this formula is correct or not. You know that magnetic field at the center of the ring is mu naught I upon 2R. Now if you put x equal to 0, you must get the same answer, because x equal to 0 means center of the ring. X equal to 0 means center of the ring, right? So let me put x equal to 0. What will you get? You will get mu naught I r square divided by 2 r cube, that is mu naught I by 2 r. You will get the same result. That means the result here is correct. Okay, if there are n turns, you just have to multiply it with n. Okay, now suppose we have a spiral. So this is a spiral. This is a spiral. This spiral has n turns which are closely bound. The inner radius of this spiral is A and the outer radius is B. So this is a coil of n turns, but this coil is not, all the coils are not of the same radius. It is like a spiral. So this is different from this case. Here what we have assumed is n turns are there, but all the turns are of same radius. But here all the turns are not of same radius. So here the turns are of different radius. So the inner radius is given as A and the outer radius is given as B. So I have drawn this here. See, this is the outer part. This is the inner part. Inner part has radius A, the outer part is radius B. Now at a distance small r, let us take an element of thickness dr. This is the elemental circle. Now because these are closely bound, you can say that you can use the linear unitary method here. b minus a. This length is how much? This length is b minus a, right? B minus a length has n turns. Then unit length will have n upon b minus a turns. Okay, then dr thickness will have n upon b minus a into dr. So this is the number of turns. This is the number of turns dn. This is the number of turns in this element. And these in this element, you can assume that all turns have same radius, that is r, because this dr is very negligibly small. So db, you will write db is equal to mu naught ni by 2r. So the magnetic field at the center is given by mu naught I by 2r multiplied by the number of turns. So in this element, the number of turns is dn. So db is equal to mu naught I by 2r into dn is n by b minus a into dr. So you will get mu naught in upon 2 into b minus a dr by r. Okay. Now again, for all elements, the field will be in the same direction. So you can directly say that b will be equal to integration db. So integration db is how much? Mu naught ni by 2 pi b minus a, 2 b minus a, these are constants. Dr upon r integration is ln r. And the integration limit will be, the first element is at r equal to a, the last element is at r equal to b. So I have directly substituted, I have directly integrated it and substituted the limits. So b is equal to mu naught in upon 2 into b minus a ln b by a. You can join me on Telegram and ask your doubts there, the link of which is given in the description box. Okay, find the magnetic field at the center in the following cases. So this is the first case. So you are given a wire. This is a semi-infinite wire. This is a semi-infinite wire. Then you have a half ring, half current carrying ring, and then again you have a semi-infinite wire. The magnetic field due to this wire at the point C is zero. Why? Because R is zero. Because this point is along the wire. Okay, so R has to be like this. Understood? DL cross R vector is zero here. Basically, DL cross R vector is zero here. Similarly, for this also, the magnetic field at point C will be zero. Same, it is along the line. Now, due to this half ring, you know that the magnetic field will be, due to the half ring, magnetic field will be how much? Mu naught I upon 2R into theta upon 2 pi. Theta upon 2 pi means pi upon 2 pi. That is equal to mu naught I upon 2R into half. That is equal to mu naught I upon 4R. And the direction will be, curl your fingers along the current. The direction of the thumb is inwards. So the direction of the thumb is inwards. That means the field will be inwards. Okay. So let us look at the next question. So again, this is a semi-infinite wire. And due to this, the magnetic field at point C is zero. Due to this, the magnetic field at point C will be how much? So the magnetic field at point C due to the half ring will be how much? Mu naught I upon 4R and inside the plane. And the magnetic field due to the second wire, the magnetic field due to the second wire will be how much? See, so the second wire is a semi-infinite wire and this is R. Okay, and if you see, if you point your thumb along the current and curl your fingers, you will see that at point C, it is curling inwards. So it will be mu naught I upon 4 pi R into 1 plus 0, sine 90 plus sine 0, and that is also inwards. So the net magnetic field at the center will be equal to mu naught I upon 4R common 1 plus 1 by pi inwards. Okay. So now we have one more question here. So this time what you have, the magnetic field due to the first wire, the magnetic field due to the first wire is mu naught I upon 4 pi r. Again, this is a semi infinite wire, and the distance of the point C from the semi infinite wire is r. So this is at point C is mu naught I upon 4 pi r, and the direction, again, point your thumb along the current, you are seeing that you will curl inwards. So this is also inwards. Then magnetic field due to the ring, the half ring, the magnetic field due to the half ring at point C will be equal to mu naught I upon 4R, and you can see that this is also inwards. Curl your fingers along the current, the direction of thumb is inwards. Then the magnetic field due to the second straight current carrying in semi-infinite wire at again point C is mu naught I upon 4 pi r, and you will see that again if you point your thumb along the current, the fingers will curl inwards. So this is also inwards. So the net magnetic field at the center will be mu naught I upon 4 pi r plus mu naught I upon 4 pi r, that is mu naught I upon 2 pi r plus mu naught I upon 4 r inwards. We have the next question here. So you can see that this straight current carrying wire will have no field at C. This straight current carrying wire will have no field at C. Okay. Similarly, this straight current carrying wire will have no field at C. So the only field will be due to this as well as this. So this is the first ring. So let the magnetic field due to this is B1, and this is the second ring. Let the magnetic field, so this is the second half ring. Let the magnetic field due to this be B2. So you will say that B1 is equal to mu naught I upon 4A, and the direction is inwards. B2 is equal to mu naught I upon 4B. The direction is again inwards. Why? Curl your fingers along the current, the thumb is pointing inwards. So the B resultant or the B net will be equal to mu naught I upon 4 1 by A plus 1 by B inwards. Now let us have a look at the next question. So you have again one ring, one half ring, one more half ring, and the magnetic field due to this wire at this point is 0. Similarly, the magnetic field due to this wire at this point is again 0. So the only thing left is this as well as this. So this time you will see that this is the first half ring, and we will say that the magnetic field due to this at the point C is B1, and this is the second half ring, and the magnetic field due to this at point C supposes B2. So you will say that B1 is equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi A. Again, the direction is inwards. Why? Curl your fingers along the current, the thumb is pointing inwards. But this time you will see that B2 is mu naught I upon 4 pi B, but the curl of the fingers this time is anti-clockwise, and the thumb will point outwards. So this time the thumb will point outwards. So the resultant magnetic field, this will be mu naught I upon 4 pi 1 by A minus 1 by B inwards. The net will be inwards. Why? Because 1 by A is greater than 1 by B. Then we have the next question here. So this is a straight current carrying wire. This is almost touching it. Then this wire makes a circle. It makes a complete circle here. And then again it forms a infinite straight current carrying wire. So we will say that this is nearly equal to R. Means this is almost closed. So this is a semi-infinite wire. This is also a semi-infinite wire, and this is a full circle. So let us assume that the magnetic field due to this is B1, the magnetic field due to this is B2, and the magnetic field due to this is B3. Then you will say that B1 is equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi R, and the direction is, so again, point your thumb along current, you will see that you will see that the fingers at point C will curl outwards. If you see B2, it will again be same mu naught I upon 4 pi r, then the curl will be outwards. Okay, now if you see this, then you will see that B3, the curl will be inwards. So B3 will be equal to mu naught I upon 2r, and this curl will be inwards. So the resultant magnetic field will be equal to mu naught I upon 2r minus mu naught I upon 2 pi r inwards. The resultant will still be inwards because this magnitude is more than the sum of these two. Okay, this time you will see that this is the current carrying wire and it makes a circle and this moves like this. So this time suppose this again, due to this it is B1, due to this it is B2, and due to this it is B3. So this time you will see that for every B1, B2 and B3, the thumb will point outwards. So B1 will be mu naught I upon 4 pi r outwards, B2 will be equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi r outwards, and B3 is equal to mu naught I upon 2 r outwards. So the resultant field will be mu naught I upon 2 r plus mu naught I upon 2 pi r outwards. In the next question you will see that due to this wire, again the magnetic field at the center is zero. Due to this wire also you can see that the magnetic field at the center is zero. So this will be zero, this will be zero. Due to this wire, the magnetic field B1 will be equal to mu naught I upon 2b, mu naught I upon 2b, suppose due to this it is B1, due to this it is B2, mu naught I upon 2b into theta upon 2 pi. I've told you this. Okay, then the direction, you can see that the fingers curl in the clockwise direction and the thumb is pointing downwards, means inwards. Similarly, B2 is pointing outwards, so it will be B2 is equal to mu naught I upon 2a into theta by 2 pi, and this is pointing outwards. So outward will be dominating. Why? Because A is smaller. So this time it B resultant will be equal to mu naught I upon 2 into theta upon 2 pi multiplied by 1 by A minus 1 by B, and the resultant will be outwards. Now we have the next question here. A current I equal to 5 ampere flows along a 5 ampere flows along a thin wire shaped as shown in the figure. The radius of curvature of the curved part of the wire is equal to r, and the angle, this angle is 2 phi is equal to 90. Find the magnetic field at the point O. Now listen to me very carefully. This, and this is the center. This is the center. This angle is given as 2 phi, and this part is missing. But this is the wire. So now this current is I, this current is also I. Yes. So now the angle made by the ring, the angle made by the ring is how much? 2 pi minus 2 phi. So the magnetic field due to the ring at point O, the magnetic field due to the ring at point O, magnetic field due to the ring at point O, let it be B1, is equal to mu naught I upon 2r into 2 pi minus 2 phi divided by 2 pi inwards. Curl your fingers along the Correct. The thumb is inwards. Okay. And due to this, now you will see that due to this, there is this angle is phi, this angle is phi. And what will be this distance? Suppose this is r, then this distance is what? R cos phi. So you will say that the magnetic field due to straight current carrying wire, straight current carrying wire, let us say B2, will be equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi, this distance is R cos phi, into sin phi plus sin phi. Into sin phi plus sin phi. And that will be equal to B2 is equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi R sin 2 sin phi by cos phi, that is 2 tan phi. So this becomes mu naught I tan phi upon 2 pi R. Okay, and the direction will be, point your thumb along the current, so you can see that the direction will be inwards. So both are inwards, so the resultant field will be B1 plus B2, that is mu naught I upon 2R into 2 pi minus 2 phi divided by 2 pi plus mu naught I tan phi divided by 2 pi R. Okay, so now you can put the values of phi and R. So this is phi, 2 phi is 90, phi is 45. I is 5 ampere, R is 120 millimeter. So when once you put the value, you will get the resultant magnetic field as 28 micro Tesla. Okay. Now let us come to the next problem. So here you can see that this is the current carrying ring. So this is the 3/4 quarter of a ring, 3/4 of a quarter, and this is 1/4 of a ring, but of a different radius. Right? So suppose due to this the magnetic field at the center is B1 and due to this the magnetic field at the center is B2. Both have the same centers. So you will say that B1 will be equal to mu naught I upon 2A into 3 pi by 2 divided by 2 pi. And that direction will be, again curl your fingers along the current, you can see that the thumb is pointing inwards. So this direction is inwards. If you see B2, then B2 will be equal to mu naught I upon 2B. The radius of this ring is B into this angle that it is subtending is pi by 2 divided by 2 pi. All right. So I am assuming this phi is pi by 2. Okay. If you want to find for any general phi, then what you will do is here you will write 2 pi minus phi, here you will write phi, okay, and this is also inwards. So B resultant will be equal to B1 plus B2, okay. So I have taken phi is equal to pi by 2, okay. Then, okay, so the next question is find the magnetic induction at the point O. If the wire carries a current of 8 ampere and has the shape shown in the figure, the radius of the curved part is R is equal to 100 millimeter. The linear parts of the wire are very long. So you have to take this as an infinite wire. Let us see the first semi-infinite wire. So the first wire is a straight current carrying semi-infinite wire. And if you look carefully, this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. So this is the xy plane. So if this is the XY plane, then this current, this straight current carrying wire is in the XY plane. So what is the magnetic field due to this straight current carrying wire? Let us redraw this diagram in this way. So this is the X-axis, this is the Y-axis. You can see that the wire is perpendicular to the wire is perpendicular to the y axis. The wire is perpendicular to the y axis, and the current is in the negative x direction, because this is the positive x direction. Out of the plane is the positive x direction, and the current is inside the plane. Inside the plane is the negative x direction. So the current is along the negative x direction and towards the negative side of the y axis, because this is the positive side of the y axis, this is the negative side of the y axis. So this is the straight current carrying wire. Now, due to the straight current carrying wire, the direction of the field will be, point your thumb along the current. The fingers will curl inwards. So if the fingers will curl inwards, that means the magnetic field will be what? Downwards. So means inside the plane. So you will say that B1 will be equal to mu naught. This is the formula for the magnetic field due to a straight semi-infinite wire. So it is equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi. This is the distance r, and the direction is minus k cap. Now let us look at this ring. This ring, you can clearly see that this ring is in the yz plane. So if this ring is in the yz plane, then the magnitude of this magnetic field at point O due to this ring will be mu naught I upon 4r. This is the half ring, mu naught I upon 2r into theta by 2 pi is half. So the magnetic field due to this half ring is mu naught I upon 4r. And if you want to find the direction, then you will see that if you curl your fingers along the ring, the thumb is pointing inwards. Now outward direction is positive x axis, so the inward direction is negative x axis, so it is minus I cap. Now the third wire, you can clearly see, is again in the yz plane. It is a straight current carrying infinite semi-infinite wire, and it is in the yz plane. So the third wire is in the yz plane, right? So if this third wire is in the yz plane, so again look carefully this diagram. If the third wire is in the yz plane, so point your thumb along the current. So you will see that the fingers will curl inward direction, that is negative x axis. So here B3 will be equal to mu naught I upon 4 pi r minus i cap. Okay, so now what will be the resultant field? The resultant field magnitude will be this two addition, and then vector addition with this. So you will get mu naught I upon 4r plus mu naught I upon 4 pi r whole square plus mu naught I upon 4 pi r whole square. Now if you take mu naught I upon 4 pi r common, you will get pi plus 1 whole square plus 1 square. That is mu naught I upon 4 pi r under root pi square plus 2 pi plus 2. So this is the resultant magnetic field. Now if you put the value of I as 8 ampere, the value of R is 100 millimeter, you will get the answer as 0.34 micro Tesla. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. Hello students, if you like my work, do hit the like button and share my work with your friends. Also, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. You'll be notified when I upload my next video.